What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in today's video I'm going to be sharing with you a bug in Revit. So an issue with Revit that I've just found out recently. Actually, a colleague of mine recommended that I check this out. He wasn't sure if it's a bug or what it is, and I think it is. I think we've found a Revit bug, and I think it's a big one because it has to do with calculations. And with Revit, you usually think that you're getting accurate numbers, and you might not be. So that's what we're going to be doing in today's video. Now, before I get into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up just below this video in the description, and then also up in the cards above. If you want to learn Revit, no matter if you're a beginner, intermediate, or even an advanced level user, there is something there for everybody. So make sure to check it out. Also there, you can find some ready-to-go Revit templates. You can find some really high quality Revit families, and we also have a plugin, so make sure to check it out. Okay, so now without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And as you can see, here I am in Revit, just at the home screen. So I'm just going to go here to new project, and then I'm just going to be using the default metric template for this one. Let's click OK. If you want to check out my custom templates, I'm going to link those up in the cards above. So anyways, here we are in Revit, and now what I'm going to do is just go here to the wall tool, and then let's create a wall. And I'm just going to be using the regular exterior brick on metal stud. So let's place a small, like 2 meter wall segment here. And also let's turn on the fine lines. Okay, so now let me show you what I'm talking about. So what I want to do for this is I want to calculate quantities for this wall, and that's where the bug is going to appear. So let's go here to view. Let's then go to schedule, and then here we have, or actually it's a material takeoff that I'm going to be creating. And then let's scroll down to walls, click OK. And here what I want to have is the wall length. So let's see here, wall length, so let's get that. I want to have the material area because for a lot of materials you're going to be calculating them by area, and then also I want the material name. And let me just move the name up, so let's have it like that. And also here in sorting and grouping, I'm going to sort it by a length and then just add a blank line, just because it's going to make it a bit easier for us to see what's going on. Okay, now let's take this schedule, and I'm just going to undock it and then dock it here off to the side so we can see it, and we can see the numbers change there. Okay, so once we have this in place, let's then select this wall segment and let's set the height to 2000 millimeters or 2 meters, so it's 2 meters tall. And then one more thing, I am just going to go here to the manage tab, and then on the manage tab let's change the project units. So we want the length to be in meters, and let's use a couple of decimal places. And then also I want my area to be again in meters with a couple of decimal places. Click OK. Okay, so now let's explore. Here we have this wall, obviously it's made out of different materials, and then here we have the length of the wall. We know the height is 2 meters, so 2 by 2 gives us 4 meters, right? Okay, everything is correct so far. Now, what happens if I want to add another wall segment here? So I'm just going to attach it here at the end point and then move it down. So we have another wall segment here. You can see here that it's this is that second wall segment that we've added. Now one more thing that I'm going to do, let's just highlight this by adding some shading so we can just see it a little bit clearer. Okay, so what's going on here? We have this wall. And then what you'll notice is that for all of the materials here, we have the length, which is 2 meters, and then the material area is 435. And it's 435 for all of them, which is obviously not true. So if you look at this wall, what you'll see is that here we have this material, this brick on the face, and that has a certain length. So if I measure this length, that's 2.175 meters. So if I just bring up my little trusty calculator here, so if I say I want 2.175 meters by the height of the wall, which is 2 meters, then I get 435. So the first one is correct. Let's then move over to the second one. So let's come back here to Revit and let's measure the metal stud layer, which is this one in the middle. So if I measure that one is 2 meters. 2 by 2 should be 4, and here it's reporting 435, and so on and so forth. So all of these should have different values, right? And they don't. So that's the bug. So it's giving you wrong calculations when it comes to wall joins. Now, actually, there is a fix to this bug, but it's only kind of a fix. So let me explain. If I decide to go to the Modify tab, and then if I go to the Geometry panel and use the Wall Joins tool and just click here in a corner, now we can play around with different wall joins. So here we have a butt, we also have the square off, which is pretty much the same in this case, and then also we have the meter option. Now the meter option is going to cut that wall just like this, kind of diagonally. And when it does that, what you'll notice is that here we're going to see some changes. So actually we're going to have different areas for different materials. So let me just leave it at that. So let's leave it at meter and let's go back to modify. Okay, so as you can see, this is now how the wall joins in. Okay, so now let's just make sure to kind of tag the materials so we know what we're working with. So I'm just going to quickly add some material tags, and let's change the scale here to 1 to 20 just to make it a bit easier to see. So okay, so here we have the gypsum wallboard, and then we have the metal studs, and then here we have the plywood sheeting, and then we have the air layer, and then we have the common brick. Okay, so now let's do our calculations. So here first we have our gypsum wallboard. So if I go here to the measure tool and measure the length of this, it's not the gypsum wallboard, this one is the brick. Okay, so if I measure the brick, it's 2.175. So as we've measured before, that's 435. So this one is correct. Let's then go for the air layer. So the air layer is giving us 417. So let's try that. I'm just going to measure the air layer and let's be accurate here. So this is giving us something like this. So this is the number that it's reporting. So let's bring out our trusty calculator, times 2, and it's giving us, yeah, that's the one, 417. So now the error layer is correct. And what you'll see is that if you do this for the rest of them, it's going to give you accurate measurements. Finally, if I measure this one is 1.8 something. So let's try that again. So times 2, because the height of the wall is 2 meters, 3.676. And then let's find that gypsum, 3.6.8. That's it. That's the one. So now we finally have the correct measurements. So that's basically how you solve this issue. Now, as I said, this is not a perfect solution, just because if you, and let me just go here to wall, let's add another wall segment here, just like that. And then if I decide to use a different wall, so something like this, this is basically how that wall is going to join. Now, if I want to get my accurate materials or accurate areas for my each material, well, in that case, if I go here to join geometry or wall joins, if I click and if I go to meter, it's going to give me this, which isn't really doesn't really look right. So you don't want to see this. This is a wrong detail. So you usually want to have it something like this. So obviously, it's not going to work if you have two different walls that are connecting. So that's an issue. However, if you just have two walls, which is something that's going to be probably the most common situation that you're going to see, well, in that case, it's going to work with that meter. It is going to give you a bit more accuracy. This doesn't seem like it's important, but I think it is. I think it should be correct. if you have a large building, this is really going to give you a significant difference in terms of the materials that you order and the materials that you actually need on site. So this is definitely something that should be fixed. Now the colleague that I've spoken to that had this issue, they've solved it simply by creating the wall just one layer at a time. So each layer was a wall for itself, and then they would connect all of that together. So it's so much more work to get accurate estimation. So I would find that annoying if I had to do something like that. So there you go. Now we have learned about a major Revit bug, and I hope they fix it in the future. Now you may notice that I'm working with Revit 2020. I've tested it in Revit 2023, and the same bug came up. So it just gave me wrong numbers here for the material takeoff. So that is an issue. That's it for this video. Make sure to tell me in the comment section below, have you experienced this yourself? Have you found this out? Did you know about this? Or do you have perhaps a solution to this issue? Also, if you want to get access to my Revit project files, you can find those on my Patreon page. So I'm going to include a link to that just below this video in the description, and then also up in the cards above. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.